Janice, and this is Collaboration Central. Welcome to episode 4. Today we're going to discuss when collaboration doesn't work. We can hardly remember a time when it wasn't part of our vocabulary. It's so prolific in business today, but having said that, there are many companies and organizations that report it as not working. Today we're going to explore just that. Stay tuned. As organizations commit to collaboration and start embracing this culture, some look at aspects of space and of teams. Space in ways that reduce closed office space and increase open plan. And teams in the way that teams are required to work together. They may be even be mandated to collaborate in key decision making, etc. There's good reason why this will fail. This is not collaboration, it's teamwork, and often it's a case of too many cooks spoiling the broth. We think about collaboration a little bit differently. Physical proximity is definitely not a prerequisite for collaboration. Technology is, and this enables people to collaborate from wherever they are. Secondly, it's not necessarily all about collaboration within a single team. Often the best collaboration comes out of cross-functional engagement or even cross-institutional. Leadership is a possible challenge in the collaborative space. Leaders often feel that they need to be validated, and teams feel the same way. Leaders need to think differently in the collaborative space. We like to call them idea curators because this really positions them as moderators within the group. And it also enables the group to feel that they're able to have discourse in a very level playing field. This is what collaboration is about. I'd like to include, as part of today's episode, a case study around Procter & Gamble. In 2000, the organization saw the oral care market as pretty static, really about the sale of toothpaste. In 2001, in the US, if you wanted your teeth whitened, you could spend around $500 and have the dentist do it. Alternatively, you could spend $200 and have the dentist create a mold for you and do some self-whitening. Or you could buy Crest White Strips for $24.95. So in 2001, Crest White Strips generated an incredible $200 million worth of revenue. But what's really interesting is the collaboration behind it. Oral Care brought in the teeth whitening experience. Home and Fabrics brought in bleach experience. And corporate R&D, novel film technology. That's cross-functional. That's as collaboration is intended, when the best minds bring the best ideas from wherever. Thank you for joining, and we'll see you next week.